It's totally worth putting in a little extra time early in life, in school and stuff, so that you get an awesome career rather than have to sort of dread going into your job. You love getting up and going into your job because you're doing really cool, fun stuff.
My daughter came along and she said, yeah, well, Dad's got the fun job, Mom's got the important job. And I grew up riding motorcycles and racing them and stuff, and so that's like what sort of set a lot of this off. And my dad was, he had a good set of tools, and he'd like give me the general idea and say, go for it, you know. Well, I wanted to be an astronaut, actually. And then I had a guidance counselor in middle school that's like, you can't do that, you have bad eyes. Like, oh my God, now what am I gonna do? And I got a job there in the summers teaching sailing. It's like, oh, this is awesome. I want a job where I can stay near the water. So I talked to the oceanography professor, and he basically set me on track. I owe that guy my career. I've told him that too. At school, I got to come out and go on a big USGS trip, and that's where it all kind of came together. So I've got to go to American Samoa, Bonaire, Hawaii a bunch of times, North Slope of Alaska to Barrow and Wainwright, but a bunch of places in Alaska that most people don't get to go to. I spend a lot of time on this boat, but I say most of my time is in the office, in the lab, working on building stuff. I mean, my office is like a workshop kind of. It's not really working on a computer doing spreadsheets or anything like that. One of the reasons I went into the, you know, ocean engineering side of things rather than being the science side, because, you know, you're more locked into what you are becoming an expert in, and I kind of like get to be an expert in helping everybody do their science. My job is to make the data collection happen. Somebody will come over with an idea, something they want to do, and it's sort of a duct tape and paperclip bubblegum together kind of thing that sort of works, and then my job would be to make it something that we can actually take into the field and make it more user-friendly and robust. So half of my time is supposed to be spent trying to figure out how to make something work or some new technology or whatever that I put together, and I'm there just because it's the first time it's been used and for sure something's going to go wrong. Don't be afraid to take things apart to see how they work. Like maybe not your parents' new key fob to their fancy new car or your new cell phone, but you know, the old garage door opener or a cell phone with a cracked screen. You'd be amazed what you learn.